Hello everyone, I welcome you all to Geeky Script. Today I am going to show you how to install the latest version of PyCharm IDE, that is version 2024.1 on a Windows operating system. And after that, I am also going to talk about how you can easily create a simple Hello World Python project within our PyCharm IDE, that is version 2024.1. So do watch the video till the end. I can guarantee if you watch the video till the end, you'll be learning a lot of new things. And still, after watching the video, if you face any issues, you can always comment in your comment sections. I'll try my best to help you. Now to install the latest version of PyCharm, you can simply go to favorite browser. Let me just simply search over here, PyCharm download, and hit enter. And immediately you'll be able to see this www.jetbrains.com as a first source result. So to click on this download PyCharm, and it's going to automatically redirect to the official site of JetBrains. So this link I'm going to provide right in our description, so you can directly use that link from our description to land over here. And once you are here, you'll be able to see that our PyCharm is available for Windows, macOS and Linux. So depending upon what operating system you are using, you need to switch to all these different tab, and then you need to proceed with that right software. Alright, so for Windows, I'm going to switch to Windows tab, and under Windows you can see that our PyCharm Professional is available along with PyCharm Community Edition. So if you use PyCharm Professional, then you will require one license, but for Community one, so that is what students are using, so for that you will not need any license. So I'll highly recommend you to download the Community one. So just simply click on the download button, and it's going to start downloading our PyCharm. So you can see it is rightly started downloading our PyCharm. I have already downloaded it, so I'll cancel this. I'll minimize my browser. I'll go to my download directory, and here you can see that our latest version of PyCharm, that is version 2024.1, is already been downloaded over here. So you just simply double click on that installer in order to install it locally on your system. So here you need to just simply click on install anyway. So that will going to ask you about administrative privileges. So you need to just simply click on yes. And once you click on yes, it's going to show you this welcome note. So welcome to PyCharm Community Edition setup. So let's first minimize our download directory. So here you can just simply click on next. So this is where our PyCharm is going to be installed. So within our C program files, they're going to create a JetBrains folder, and within JetBrains folder, it's going to create our PyCharm Community Edition. All right, and you can see that total space required is 1.7 gigabyte. All right, so that's the important part. So you need to have that much amount of free space on your C drive. All right, so everything is fine. Just simply click on next. So here under installation options, you can see you have several check boxes. So I'm going to check it one by one. So first one is PyCharm Community Edition desktop shortcut. So similar to Intel IDE IDEA, it's going to create another desktop shortcut over here. And with next option that we have is add open folder as project. So what that basically means is, so whichever folder you are creating, so only right clicking at that folder, it's going to show you this additional option called open folder as project. So when you click on that, it's going to open that folder, that Python project folder within our PyCharm. So that will really help you to open any folder quickly to PyCharm. So that's why it is highly recommend to check this option. Then next option is .py. .py basically means Python file extension. So we are installing PyCharm for Python projects only, right? So that's why associated language is .py. So that is why it is important to check. Now the final one is this add bin folder to path. This is the most important part. So you need to check this, as what happens is it's going to automatically set your environment in a path on our environment variable. So that's why it is really important. Only thing is, it will require to restart your system. So I'm going to show you that exact point when you need to restart. Don't worry, just watch the video till the end. So you need to keep everything as selected, and then click on next, and it's going to create a JetBrains folder, which is again totally fine. Click on install, and there you go. You can see our installation is rightly began. Also desktop shortcut is rightly created over here. So it will take some time, about a couple of minutes to get it finished installing. So after that, I'm going to again come back to this video. So we'll come back and now you can clearly see that our PyCharm Community Edition setup is successfully installed. You can see completing PyCharm Community Edition setup. So now here is the step. So you need to click on this reboot now. So what that means is when you click on finish, after that it's going to automatically restart your system and then it's going to again come back to your desktop. All right, so this is the point where you need to restart your system. So please do restart your system. After that I'm going to again come back to this video. So welcome back. So after successfully restarting your system, will be again landed over to the desktop, and here you can see PyCharm Community Edition desktop shortcut is also created. So you need to just simply double click on that shortcut to launch our PyCharm. So you can see PyCharm Community Edition version 2024.1 is rightly started launching. So it will ask you to give some permission to our firewall. So just simply click on allow and you can see that our PyCharm is rightly open. So in my previous videos, I have showed you how to install IntelliJ IDEA. So it is telling whether you like to import all the settings whichever you have made on IntelliJ IDEA, whether you like to import the same to our PyCharm. So you can always import that if you have previously installed, or for now if you are fresh starting to install PyCharm. So for that you can just simply click on skip import. So that will going to launch our welcome to PyCharm. Alright, so let's first maximize this. And you can see this is the interface of our PyCharm. You can always create a new project. So for that you need to click on this, you know, plus icon, that is new project. So here you need to give your project name. So let's give the project name as Hello World, right? And it's going to create our project within this location. So on our users directory, it's going to create this PyCharm projects folder, and within PyCharm projects folder it's going to create this our project called Hello World. All right, and you know, next options are, you know, create a Git repository if you want to connect your project with some Git repository. So that also you can do. But if you are a beginner, you don't know much about Git, you can uncheck this for now. And next option is create a welcome script. So I recommend you to select this. So it's going to create a default Hello World Python project along with your main project. So I recommend to select that. And next is this, you know, Python version. All right. So I don't have Python installed right now on my system. So what it's going to do is it's going to automatically download the latest version of Python, that is version 3.12.2, along with our PyCharm, and it's going to, you know, set up everything for us. All right, you don't need to manually install Python. So, you know, keep it default. If you want to change the version to some older version, so that also you can select from this drop down. I'm going to keep the default one, which is 3.12.2. at the time of making of this video. So everything is fine. Click on create. So that's going to start creating our project. So you can see it is right started. Only thing is you need to have active internet connection. So, you know, it will take some time, about 3 minutes I would say. So after that I'm going to again come back to this video. So welcome back. And now you can clearly see that our project is rightly open and it is indexing our Python. So let's wait for a minute to get it finished indexing our Python. And you can see that our indexing is rightly done, our project is rightly opened. So you can maximize our PyCharm IDE, and you can see here is our project and here is our main.py file. So they have given a sample code here as well. So if you click on this run button, it's going to start immediately building our project, and after it gets successfully built, it's going to show you the output, Hi PyCharm. Alright. So hopefully these videos are helping you. If these videos are really helping you, please do like, share and comment. That will really motivate me to make more such videos. And if you are interested, you can also subscribe our Geeky Syntax channel. So here regularly I am posting coding related videos. And you can also subscribe our Geeky Script blogging channel as well. So that is basically all about this video. Thank you very much for watching this video and God bless you all.